Yeah, you should have chose a depend.
I wet my pants. I did.
I feel like I'm about to ask you guys to bid on products or something, and don't say a dollar. All right, we're looking here at two cans of the popular sanitary spray or whatever you call it, air freshener, Febreze. Now I'm going to ask you guys, on the left, it is spelled F-E-B-R-E-Z-E, and on the right, it is spelled F-E-B-R-E-E-Z-E. Which is the right Febreze?
Okay, well, the left one is correct with the single E's, but they're both wrong, but I'm going to save it.
All right, which one? What do you think, Rob?
It's got to be the second one. That Fabreze is the first one.
No,
Fabreze.
Fabreze.
Here's another one that says that the way that you want to spell it, F-E-B-R-E-Z.
Clearly a knockoff.
But no, this is correct. This is how it's spelled.
Really?
So big.
Yeah. I'm from another dimension, I'm pretty sure.
Well, you know how products do that. They always spell things weird to be all edgy and
no,
fun.
I'm feeling weird. I'm feeling really weird right now. Like, I don't even know. Yeah. I can't even tell Mona Lisa apart from other stuff. Like, what? So did like a nuclear bomb go off a couple years ago and just like completely flip the game or something? Like, what is going on?
I am not even sure that we're in a real show right now. I'm not sure if this is a real show.
Is this a real show?
This might not be. Probably isn't sounding much like one, but I'm going to ask you guys about a fast food place now. Now, how do you guys say Chick-fil-A? How is chick spelled in Chick-fil-A?
Oh, no. Like chic, I guess. You know what? I'm so scrambled. I don't even know anymore.
Look, I'm showing you a picture. Look at the sign up there. What's it say? It says CHIC dash Chick-fil-A, just like you say.
Chili, what?
Yeah, like
yeah.
Cheek, like cheek is
yeah,
what
chic.
It is
like
there.
CHIC, okay.
Okay, what I'm showing you is correct. CHIC, like that?
I mean,
Chick-fil-A.
I hope so,
right.
Yeah.
No, okay. I well, in my mind, I'm picturing...
No!
What is that?
No!
That's the actual logo of Chick-fil-A. That's what it's called. It's called Chick, C-H-I-C-K.
No, you're wrong.
I'm so angry right now. Are you sure?
I love this. I love that you guys keep telling me wrong as if I'm just cannot be fact checked. This is great. Yeah.
You're wrong. That's wrong.
Well, I don't think that it's so impossible that there could be both.
Well, I lived in Florida. Florida's like another dimension, and there was a Chick-fil-A there, and I'm pretty sure that it was the other way.
Now,
that's all I'm saying.
Yeah, it's easy to remember it as being chic, like it's trying to sound fancy, but it's never been that. It's always been what I'm showing you. Those other ones, I don't know.
Also, where did those signs come from?
I don't know if those were photoshopped or in some other dimension and someone has some kind of portal camera. I'm not sure.
Another dimension.
What the fuck? Come on.
I want to stay with food. So I'm going to talk about one of my favorite candy bars right now, Kit Kat. Now, Kit Kat, when you see the logo, does it have a dash between the two words or is it just one word mushed together?
It's supposed to have a dash. Please stop. This is torture. Okay.
Like this, right? Welcome showing you this Kit Kat.
Yes.
Yeah, that's with the dash.
Whoa. That package has both.
Where?
Go back. That package has both.
Look at the bottom. It doesn't have it. But that's because this is the actual logo for Kit Kat. Just one word mashed together with two capital K's, but there's never been a dash between it. That's silly.
I remember
the dash as well. It's very, very strange of all the, you know, of
I
all
think
the
it's just,
things that could change, just missing a dash.
Yeah, it's just revisions. It's just revisions done by the marketing board. I don't know.
Even the K's look different. Like Drea, you're a graphic designer. You do this stuff every
day. Rebranding.
Does that look like the Kit Kat? Like that looks correct to me. Go back to the other one.
Yeah, the dash, right?
Dash looks correct. This looks all fucking. That looks all cheesy. Like someone, I don't know.
That's the rebrand. All these people are doing rebrands, and they're going in the wrong direction.
Then it would rebrand it when it started because it's always been that.
Ugh, so
I'm tripping out right now.
There's another one. All right. No, yeah, because I want to fly through. There's so many. There's so many we won't even get to. But I want to talk about something that's concerned me and my family for many years, and that's side view mirrors. So we all know
your whole family's upset about side view mirrors.
We're passionate about safety, about vehicular safety. Now, what do you guys remember being printed in the inside of side view mirrors? It's always been text in them. So what does that text say?
Objects in mirror may be closer than they appear.
Okay, and I'm showing you an image. Does this look correct? Objects in mirror may be closer than they appear. They may be.
Yeah, they might.
That look right to you, Rob? Maybe yes. Closer than they appear?
That's what I remember exactly, too, yeah.
I'm more concerned about the image in that mirror. What the fuck is that?
They're going to run that couple over.
Another thing... Yeah, that she looked pregnant in the picture. I'm not sure.
Oh my god!
You know, I used
it's a massacre.
Here's the actual because no one, you know, people love parodies of things, especially parodies of rearview mirrors. And this has socialism background in the mirror. It says, "Warning: objects in mirror may be closer than they appear."
Okay. I don't even get that joke.
It's just a parody. Here's a great parody mug, and it says, "Caution: spinning elbows may be closer than they appear." And there's a guy like chopping the W in elbows.
Oh, so nice.
Maybe. We're all established that maybe closer than they appear is just what mirrors say, right?
And here's something.
Objects in the rearview mirror may appear closer than they are. Rock and roll dreams come through. Bat out of hell, too. Back into hell. Okay. We've all established now.
Love Meatloaf. Meatloaf is the best. Meatloaf's
getting in on it already. But this is what it actually says on every mirror ever. Objects in mirror are closer than they appear. The end.
No.
Not maybe.
No.
There's maybe to it. It's always been that.
No.
I remember it being much more polite. I remember it being much more polite. It said
I remember the cadence being different because I remember as a kid, because, you know, back in the days, we didn't have cell phones and iPads and shit to be distracted. So on long car drives, I was staring at that thing and reading it, and there was a lilt to it. I made it a little song in my head. So no.
Well, it is this one.
I'm about to go look at my rearview mirror real quick.
Yeah.
Stay where you are. We'll all check our rear views later because I do it every night anyway because my family loves safety. Now, speaking of mirrors, I want to talk about Snow White. And what I want to ask you guys, what is the famous line that the queen says to the mirror? She says,
"Oh no,
mirror, mirror
on the wall." Okay. Who's the fairest of them all?
Right. That's how we remember it, guys. We're fair. Look, just like this book says, mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all? That's right. We all agree?
Well, that's not what you... No, the one in the picture is not even... See, that's saying who... Wait, go back. It says mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest one of all?
We're not worried about that second line. I want to talk about the first line. Mirror, mirror on the wall.
Oh, that's the one that's in question? Yeah.
No, I'm asking, is that right? Yeah. That's what it's always been, right? And we see in this book again here, mirror, mirror on the wall. Who in this land is fairest of all? That seems to change a little bit. But we can all agree it's mirror, mirror, right?
Yes.
Here we go. That evening, as usual, the queen asked the mirror, mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all? Well, let's hear the actual audio from Snow White, please.
Slave in the magic mirror, come from the farthest space. Through wind and darkness, I summon thee. Let me see thy face.
What wouldst thou know, my queen?
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
There it is. Magic mirror on the wall. Let's hear it again, clipped.
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
It's always been magic mirror, evidently, but I always remembered it as mirror, mirror, and I've heard it regurgitated just through pop culture forever. It's always been that. It's weird.
Maybe, you know how all these Disney films were based off of a lot of fairy tales that existed before? Maybe, you know, they just did that line differently for the movie, and we're still reading the books of Snow White.
Possibly.
I mean, yeah. Possibly, I'm really struggling to hold on to reality here.
Yeah.
So,
As we Please. Look at these pages in these books, too, it may be that. But if you'd think that if, you know, I remember seeing the movie quite a bit. I used to even replay it in theaters. We'd go see it at camp and kids and stuff. I always remember
wow,
it being
you really love
mirror.
That movie.
Love it.
He just loves mirrors. You got to remember, he loves mirrors.
That's true.
Look,
I'm afraid
I'm telling
of
you, this is probably where it came from. Magic mirror on my car. How maybe that car very far. I don't know. So there's other Disney related ones, like, you know, that blue logo before the old Disney VHSs that showed the castle, and remember, like, before every Disney home video,
yeah,
and Tinkerbell would fly out and she would tap the top of the circle and the eye to Disney, right? Tinkerbell evidently never flew out. That never happened.
What?
It might have been on one thing, but it's not the thing that you know.
We were just all on drugs.
There's a video of a guy trying to recreate it, and it looks real crappy, but when he shows it, you're like, yeah, that's what it's supposed to look like, but it never did. Tinkerbell never flew out from behind the castle and ticked the little eye of Disney to make the circle. But
You're a liar now. Come on, I remember
I'm
that.
I'm really gonna cry.
I'm really not. It's really hard to find something that it can actually prove that that was on everything that we ever saw.
What about Peter Pan? What about the Peter Pan movie itself?
You mean the intro of her doing that?
Yeah, like
I don't. It's that is not a thing, evidently.
All right, I have a question about all of this.
Sure.
What is the point of all of these things being changed? Why would they do this? Why would these things be different?
I don't know. We're gonna get into some more and talk about that because that's there's more before we can even kind of figure this out. So I want to talk about movies still. You guys like James Bond?
I love James Bond.
Hell yeah! Hell yeah! That
all right, like Rob, who's your favorite Bond?
My favorite Bond? I like the new Bond a lot. What's his name?
Daniel Craig.
I like Daniel Craig a lot, but Sean Connery is the best. Is the best Bond, like classic Bond.
Yeah. Sadly, as an '80s kid, man, I respect Sean Connery and all that. Don't get me wrong. I even like Dalton. And
Pierce Brosnan was even cool, man. Like GoldenEye. GoldenEye's great.
I have things to say about that.
But Roger Moore. So I like Roger Moore. But the movie Moonraker. Do you guys remember Moonraker and the villain Jaws?
Yes.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Now, do you remember Moonraker enough to remember the character Dolly, the young female in the movie?
I don't
remember Dolly.
Well, there's a scene where some stuff falls on Jaws, and you guys all remember Jaws. Jaws is known for what? For his metal teeth that could just eat James Bond's whole body if it wanted to.
yeah, super sexy.
So the villain Jaws gets knocked out, and there is a young girl character, not young, I mean, she's in her 20s, but she's, you know, got like pigtails, this character Dolly. And when he is getting up from this pile of rubble, he looks at her and she smiles at him, showing her braces, and he shows his metal teeth. And then they end up falling in love because they got this kind of metal mouth thing in common. Does that ring any bells?
No, regrettably. Well, I'm sorry. I'm not as big a James Bond fan as I just earlier said I was.
It's a strange thing because everyone seems to remember the character Dolly having braces, and the whole purpose of the scene and the way that they bond and fall in love is because she smiles, he sees she has metal teeth, and he smiles and shows his, and they're like, oh, we have something in common. Well, evidently Dolly never had braces, even though everyone remembers her having braces. It's a very strange one.
Yeah. What would be the point of that scene then? That's so weird.
It makes no sense anymore. And people have found like stills with it, and people have analyzed the videos of this. This, if you really want to go in the wormhole, go start watching videos on Dolly, James Bond, Mandela, because they go in and they'll show you like that it looks like digital editing on her teeth. And you can see like, I'll say it again, residue from that.
There's
all kinds of residue in this one, but it's a weird one, and because the scene makes no sense. It makes sense the way it's remembered, not the way that it actually is. Yeah. And
why wouldn't they just cut out the scene entirely if they didn't like it? And again, what's the point? Why would they even do that?
And even the actress herself has had to ask for it. And, you know, if it is just weirdly misremembered, it'd be a weird thing to have to answer to. But she says, no, I never had braces for the movie.
People
are sticking with it, saying that she always did. And that's another one. And I want to ask you about Anne Rice's first vampire book. What was that called?
Oh, geez. I don't know. I don't read.
Interview with.
Oh, probably a vampire. Yeah. Interview with the vampire.
Which one is it, A or
it's the? It's the.
Okay, what about you, Rob? Is Interview with a Vampire or the Vampire?
Going with my gut from memory as a kid, because I remember it being said, Interview with a Vampire.
Okay, and I'm showing you guys a trivia question card. And the first question is, name Anne Rice's first vampire novel, and the answer is Interview with a Vampire. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
That was written by a plebeian.
And we can see playing at the Plaza West Cinema, you have Interview with a Vampire and also The Santa Claus, which hasn't changed.
It's not a Santa Claus. It's the Santa Claus.
Interview with a Vampire. But Dreas, you're from the timeline that is correct. That Interview with the Vampire is what it is.
Right. Man, this is another one.
No, okay, here. I'm going to give people a little bit of clearance here, because like I said, with many of these, easy mistake to make. Look at what the word with ends with a TH. Interview with the. So it sounds like with a, you know?
You're right.
It's very easy to make.
And there's another one that's like that too, and that is you guys Pink Floyd fans.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, like a hardcore Pink Floyd fan.